Satnam, over the past few weeks, I've had several requests from all over the world to say something about the coronavirus and how to deal with it, how to build your immunity. So many questions coming in from emails, on Facebook, on Instagram. So I thought I'll use this platform to convey what I am doing for myself and what I feel you should be doing to protect yourself and your family. So I'm going to divide what I have to say to you in a few parts where there will be several videos coming out related to your health, your body, the mind, and the spiritual aspect of this situation that we are in right now. So starting with now, I'm going to tell you about building up the immunity of the body. So I am a big proponent of Ayurveda and naturopathy, and it's a very simple reason is that I was afflicted with arthritis at the age of 33. I had extremely high cholesterol and I had eczema, which was spreading like wildfire all over my body. And any doctor will tell you that arthritis is not curable, eczema is not curable. But in my case, Ayurveda helped me to overcome this huge, huge, huge problem of my life, in my body, in my health. So being this huge fan of Ayurveda and being a big proponent of it, I'm going to tell you what the basic principle of Ayurveda related to disease is. The basic principle of Ayurveda is that you don't wait for the disease to hit you, but prepare the body so that the disease never hits you. Ayurveda is more of a preventive science than a curative science. Okay, so from that point of view, the mental attitude as far as your body is concerned for defeating coronavirus is to first assume that you already have it. That's the way I live my life. I am now doing everything I would do if I already had the virus inside me. What would I do? I would build up my immunity to fight it. Okay. The most important thing in that, the most important, the number one, is your sleep. I know you all have this forced vacation and it's really, really easy to sit down now and catch up on your Netflix shows, your Amazon shows, and, you know, binge watch. In fact, a lot of the celebrities I watch on the newspaper talking about what they're doing nowadays, most of them, like at least 6 out of 10, have said binge watching. Okay, great. You want to do that? Do it during the day. Not at the cost of your sleep. The number one biggest defense your body has against a disease, against a virus, is the rest that you get when you sleep. In that deep state of sleep, your body is healing itself. So make sure that you're sleeping at 10:30 at night, waking up at 5:36 in the morning. This is not negotiable. It's number 1, 2, 3 on the list. The most important thing that you will do, sleep on time. Get enough of rest, get at least 7 hours of sleep every day. The second thing I do to build up this immunity in my system is that I wake up in the morning and the first thing that I'm doing is drinking hot water with turmeric, dry ginger powder, lemon, and moringa powder. Now, turmeric, as we know, according to Ayurveda, is the biggest antibiotic in the world. There is nothing that nature or man can produce which is more potent as an antibiotic than turmeric. And moringa powder is one of the superfoods that we have in our lives as a gift from God, which help not only to build our immunity, but it's also carcinogenic, which means that it is the biggest prevention that you have against cancer. So it makes you strong. It builds your body and it builds your immunity. So this concoction is something that I have every single morning. Sometime during the day, at least twice a day, I'm also taking tulsi, which is holy basil leaves. I'm putting it in water. I'm boiling about 7 leaves in that water. And I drink that warm. Tulsi leaves are known to be really, really, really beautiful solving your flu symptoms, flu problems, cold, coughs and everything, but also builds immunity. So that's the third thing that they're on my list. Throughout the day, you sip hot water. Again, it's something which if you already had a cold, if you already had a cough or fever, this is something, what do you think fever is? Fever is raising the body's heat inside the body, the temperature inside the body, so that the virus that is present in the body gets killed with that heat. Now, why not kill the heat from an external source like hot water? So if you're just sipping hot water throughout the day, what you're doing is you're building the heat in your throat area and you are killing the virus, which is now growing over here, right? So this one thing which you do anyway, which also means that your biggest enemy right now, your enemy number one, is anything that comes out of the refrigerator, cold water, cold drinks, cold, nice, you know, chilled wine, champagne. Avoid that now, because all this builds up your kapha. All this is creates the perfect breeding ground for germs and viruses to develop inside the body. Avoid all of that right now. Also, what you have to avoid is white sugar. Again, white sugar is something which is the best friend for cancer. It's the best friend for cold, for kapha, for all kinds of diseases known to man. So if you eliminate that now, you're enhancing your body's strength to build up that immunity that the body needs desperately right now to be in the shape and strong to protect yourself from any virus that can hit your body right now. The other thing you need to avoid is oily and greasy food. Not happening. For the time being, just stay out of it. One thing I want to talk about is earthing. I don't know if you know about it. What you do is, if you have the luxury of having a space which is not covered in concrete or marble, or you know, something which is natural, where you can go to a natural ground, and if you just stand on it, the radiation that comes from the ground, it forms a kind of an electric circuit for your body to heal itself. Okay, it's a long science, which I don't want to get into right now, otherwise this video will get too long. I would suggest you Google it and you watch this, just Google this word called earthing, and you get your feet directly in connection to the ground, not wearing your favorite Nike or Adidas shoes, barefoot on the ground, okay, and see what that does to your body, earthing. Another thing you can do to build in your immunity is fasting. You can do the intermittent fasting, there's a lot of material out there for you to learn from. You have your last meal at 7:30 in the evening, and you don't eat till your breakfast, which is at 7, or your lunch, depending upon how long you can hold on. Fasting also builds up the immunity. It allows the body to get rid of all the garbage that might be there in it, so that your body is clean and receptive to the nutrition that you give it, when you give it the right kind of nutrition. The other thing that Ayurveda strongly advises is licking honey. Now, there's a big difference between having 2 spoons of honey and the honey going clap down into your stomach and into your body. Or what Ayurveda needs is you take a stick, maybe like a wooden stick, and you just lick it. Why? Because when you lick it, it just stays in this portion for much longer. And this is the portion which is generating the kapha, the mucus. If the honey goes in and stays here for a longer period, because you've licked it instead of gulping that big spoon down, it has a higher and a much stronger chance to deal with that mucus and the kapha and defeating it. So you just lick honey. Now, there's lots more that I want to say. I'm going to break it up into other videos as well. But this is the gist of everything. And to summarize everything, number one, sleep. Just sleep properly at the right time. Wake up at the right time. That's the best gift you can give yourself right now. Start your day with turmeric, dry ginger powder, lemon and moringa powder. Fresh tulsi leaves, holy basil, you just heat it up in twice a day and you drink that. Throughout the day, sip hot water. Don't even look at a refrigerator for cold water, cold drinks, aerated drinks, your beer, champagne, none of that right now. Avoid anything that makes your body acidic. Have foods and live a life which makes your body more alkaline, which also means meditation, because when you meditate, the alkalinity of the body increases. Acidity also comes with stress, fear, tension, anxiety. Avoid. When you meditate, you get rid of all of that. Your body becomes more alkaline and you are healthier. Excuse me. Avoid oily and greasy foods. Understand the concept and meaning of earthing, so that you know you use this simple, beautiful mechanism to heal the body and get it in balance, getting a chakra in balance. Fasting, and finally licking honey. More to come soon. Thank you very much for watching. Satnam.